We're about ready to begin. I want to welcome everybody here. Hope everybody's having a wonderful feast. And we're going to have opening prayer now by our pastor Manny Ross.
Thank you, Father in heaven, for the people that are here, your people, whom you call out of this world, and whom you're teaching your truth day after day. There's not one of us that knows everything that we should know, but we ask you to reveal more, to inspire the speaker, to give him a portion of the Holy Spirit for this service, and so that he can teach us more. We want to learn more about you. We know that the world is a mess, but Father, we want to put the world, our lives, in your hands. May your kingdom come, and thank you for this meeting that we're having and for allowing us to keep the Feast of Tabernacles here. Amen.
Okay, let's everyone rise now, and we will sing a couple hymns here and rejoice. We need to be rejoicing in this opportunity to picture the millennium of what it's going to be like. Like you just said, it's a wretched world we're living in right now. But we know there's a great future ahead, thanks to God. Okay, we're going to start with our first hymn, Trust and Obey.
Yeah.
And that's page 47. That might help you out a little bit. Page 47, Trust and Obey. Blessed assurance. Just a short way. So If you have any questions, ask Jim, he'll be able to get you, there.
You go down to 400, I don't know what the street name is, but highway is 400, turn left towards the river, and you'll be there.
What's the name of the restaurant?
It's called Chart House, it's right in the marina.
And that's my pleasure, introduce a very good friend of mine for our sermon today, our friend.
Thank you, Court. That's my, that's sort of black in the face.
What toy is it?
All right.
He wanted to see you.
Oh, really?
I don't know, I don't know what you want to do.
Nope, it won't.
What's the matter?
Can't see me?
Can you see well?
Clear.
Yeah, I can see.
That, a little better?
Yeah, I don't need it.
You don't need it?
Nah.
Okay. That's all the problem with it.
Today, my sermon is gonna be a little bit different, because we've all been discussing these tabernacles, and most of us know what it is. Friday, I'm gonna go into it more, but Manny's been into it, Court's been into it. So today, I don't know that, I think that some people don't really know about the Trinity. That's what I'm gonna talk about. Is there really three gods in heaven? You know, years ago, I went to the Free Methodist Church, I was going, I said, I'm talking 50-some years ago, how old was it? And I listened, I heard Herb Armstrong, I read him, talking. I told one of the people at the church, I said, I've been listening to Mr. Armstrong, and boy, I'm telling you, he tells it like it is. Oh, you don't want to go, he don't believe in the Trinity. He's gotta be an atheist. So, Deuteronomy, if you'd go there with me, Deuteronomy, that's hard to say, 6 and verse 4. Deuteronomy 6 and verse 4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. One what? Is it one being or one family? Verse 5, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your strength. The Lord is one, but he's also unity. I'll get into that later. Mark 12 and 29, verse 29. Mark 12, 29. Some people say, well, you know, you don't have to go by the Old Testament anyway, you know. We don't have to keep the old laws. They're all done away with. They're nailed to the cross. In Mark 12:29, Jesus answered, first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, our Lord God, is one, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. Excuse me. What he just did there is summed up the first four, love toward God. The last six commandments is love toward man. And the original Greek word or Hebrew word, Genesis 2:24. Therefore, a man shall leave, Genesis 2:24. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. That one is a Strong's number 259. Properly united or first is what Strong says it is. It's not one. And the King James translated it as alike, alone, altogether, any, a piece, a certain, each, one, 11, every few, first, highway, a man, once, one. So there was many translations of that word. Excuse me. Mark 10, verse 5. And Jesus answered and said to them, because of the hardness of your heart, he wrote you this precept. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. They'll be no longer two, but one. See, we're two separate beings. Me and my wife are one. According to God, we're one. But in unity. But not one being. We're still two beings. We're still two people. And the Greek word for one is Strong's number 1520. Excuse me. As opposed to many, it says here in Strong's. So they're basically the same. And Genesis 11, 1. Genesis 11. It came to pass, now the whole world had one language and one speech. We're talking about the Tower of Babel. And it came to pass that they journeyed from east and west, they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. Then they said to one another, come, let us make up bricks and take them thoroughly. They had brick for stone, and they also asphalt for mortar. And they said, come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower whose top of the heavens. So what they wanted to do is they wanted to build a tower so that if there was another flood, it wouldn't kill them. They wanted to go beyond what God. They wanted to go beyond God. They wanted to outpower God. So we'll make a name for ourselves. At least we be scattered abroad from the face of the whole earth. But the Lord came down the city and the tower which the sons and men had built. And the Lord said, indeed, the people are one. There we go, one. Now there's a whole bunch of people there built that tower. How could they be just one? They have one language. What they begin to do, now nothing that they propose to do will be withheld from them. Come, let us go down there and confuse their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from there over the face of all the earth. They ceased the building. City, of course, couldn't understand each other. Therefore, its name is called Babel, or Babel, however you want to pronounce it, because there the Lord confused the language and all of them scattered around over the face of the earth. And that Greek word again, well, that's a New Testament Greek word. Sorry about that. Let's go to John 10, verse 30. Really ain't no need to go in there because there's only one little verse. He said, I and my Father are one. Trinity people say three in one in John 20, verse 17. John 20, verse 17. I'll have this marked, but I guess it didn't get the old feeble-minded. John 20, 17. This we're talking about. Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and she, let's see, let's go back up to. Okay, they asked Mary in verse 13, 20 verse 13. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "Because they've taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they have laid him." Now when she said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there and didn't know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?" She supposed him to be the gardener. Said to him, "Sir, if you had carried him away, tell me, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." This was Mary Magdalene, of course, that put oil on his feet, and they all got mad about it because they were wasting the oil on Jesus. And she loved Jesus very much. There's many stories about Mary Magdalene, but she was a righteous person, very righteous. She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which is to say teacher. Jesus said to her, "Don't cling to me. I have not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren and say to them, I am ascended to my Father and your Father, and my God and your God." So there's two there. Father up in heaven, Jesus was down there. It wasn't three. Lost the place. I remember years ago, this was the Garcetta on the radio. This was back in the 70s. And he was talking about the Trinity. He said, if it's three of everything, how come we got two eyes, two nostrils, two arms, two legs? And then he'd say, "Send for the booklet." He never would answer the question. Finally, one day he was talking about that, and we were coming back from Florida. We brought a load of Christmas trees down to Florida. Sell them. This is, I'm talking about 1978. It's 77. No. 75, a long time ago. Before it was in the church, we got the church in 75, so it had to be before then. We stopped in a hotel, turned on the TV in the morning, and it said the Garner Ted Armstrong program on television. And I told her then, I said, go down to the phone booth. That day they had no cell phones, you know. I said, go down to the phone booth and order that booklet. I forgot what he was even talking about. And they said, "Well, do you want the plain truth?" And she says, "Well, whatever it is, go ahead and send it." So that kind of started into it. But Ted was a very good speaker. And I thank God that we were called into the church. And at that time, it was 1974. And we started reading those booklets. I'm off the subject here a little bit, but that's okay. We started reading those booklets, and Ruth Ann's uncle came over, and he was reading about not eating pork. And he and her uncle said, "Well, I suppose that means you're not going to make me no pork for Easter anymore." Yes, now, LG. So, in Matthew 1, verse 18. That was a long time ago, but I thank God for it. So, verse 18 in Matthew 1 says, "Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit." Wait a minute. The Holy Spirit was Jesus' father then, if he's me. It wasn't God the Father. That's what it says. Then the Holy Spirit, by the way, is power. It's something that God gives to us. I asked for the Holy Spirit to be with me up here before I got up here. I remember a friend of mine told me one time, he said, I thought I was the greatest speaker in the world. He said, I got up there one time and I didn't say a word. Because I thought it was all me. He said, before you ever get up there, make sure you ask God to give you the Holy Spirit. He said, I got up there, I had to sit out, couldn't talk. That gave me a lesson of humility. So, okay, I'm going to read chapter 22. Verse 19. Then Joseph, her husband, began being a just man, not wanting to make her public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take you, Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you will call his name Jesus, and he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done, and it was made so that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. So we know very good and well that Jesus wasn't, or the Holy Spirit wasn't Jesus' father. It was a power of the Holy Spirit that impregnated, of God the Father, that impregnated Mary.
Things looking bad. It's looking really bad.
don't care who gets elected president. Could be the sign of revelation, sorry, no. Cut off my fan wagon here a little bit. But on either side of the river, there was a tree of life, which bore 12 fruits, each tree yielding its fruit every month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. We need that, I said, right now. There should be no more curse, but the throne of God and the Lamb shall be in it. And his servants shall serve him. They shall see his face, and his name shall be on their forehead. There shall be no night there. We're talking about the new Jerusalem, the city that comes down, what John sees come down out of heaven, which was 12,000 miles high, 12,000 miles deep, and 12,000 miles each way. That's a lot of miles. That's all the way from here to Michigan. Oh, that's a big city. And I can't understand it, but as spirit beings, we can't understand being a spirit being. We don't know. I know that as the Bible says, Jesus walked right through the wall and lives in there, probably hiding, and he comes right through the wall. The doors were locked. He come and got, the Holy Spirit got Peter out of prison. I locked all things. Holy Spirit, or the spirits can do a lot, folks. They should, they'll need no lamp there, nor light of the sun. For the Lord God gives them life. They shall reign forever and ever. And there again, that's what we're looking forward to. I said I wasn't going to get into these tabernacles, but it does. It's what we're looking forward to as we're celebrating these feasts. The last great day celebrates the coming of the millennium, the Sabbath. If you want to speak that last great day recommends the 1,000-year Sabbath. And which will be teaching people, hopefully. So we see no mention of the Holy Spirit here, ruling with God, the Father, and the Lamb, which is Christ. Holy Spirit ain't ruling, it's not a person. People get mad at you if you tell them that. Oh man, the Trinity, that's... You've got to believe that Trinity. So folks, in closing, I hope we'll all be in that holy city one day. The one that's 12,000 miles high, 12,000 each way. So what we have shown here is that there are two separate beings. God the Father, God the Son. There's not three. That's a power. As Mr. Armstrong used to say, you can't see electricity, but it's power. And the Holy Spirit is like electricity. It does things, it powers things, but yet you can't see it. So, like I said, my wife and I are one unity and accord. But we're both separate beings. There again, that's two. That was two. Two beings. You got two beings. But you're still one. How about that? So the Holy Spirit's a power of both God the Father and God the Son. And folks, I hope you have a very good feast. And I think so far we're having a wonderful one. Thank you.
Thank you for that message. And now I'd like to have everybody rise. We will sing our last hymn here for the day, which is going to be page 11. Everyone will rise. And we will sing page 11, which is going to be Count Your Blessings.
I know.
what I think that we look around at what is happening in this world today.
Yes.
What a great blessing it is to know that we have been called and given God's Holy Spirit, as he just talked about. You know, that each and every one of us have that great opportunity to be in his kingdom.
Amen.
And waiting for it. And it could be a lot closer than we think, the way things are going. Okay. Page 11, count your blessings.
Oh my God.
It's not her fault, folks.
No, we know it.
That's even worse than yesterday.
Water did have a little impact on that piano.
That water messed you up, Pat.
It's a honky tonk, I told you.
Let's try it again.
Let us not be led into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom,